check the DNS whether it is working or not. Means, I mean, running or not.
Okay.
Service named start.
Yeah, service named status first.
Yeah, No. Yeah,
that service is not started yet. Okay, yeah. Start this service now. Right, so it is started. Now, check the host name of this computer.
Host name.
How can we check the host name of the computers?
By typing host name.
Yes, the command is host name.
Host name.
Yeah.
Service.
Okay. Now we'll check the DNS service, whether it is working properly or not. Okay.
Okay.
Then what we have to do for checking the DNS service here?
DNS service for checking, we need to...
status.
No, the status is a command for checking whether the service is running or not.
Yeah.
Now I'm asking about whether it is working or not. It's properly configured or not, how we can check that?
It's like dig server, dig dot server dot hari dot com.
Exactly. So we need to dig the server name so that if you get the IP address of that server name, it means your DNS server is working.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, so dig the server name. DIG space
server dot hari dot com.
Server dot hari dot com.
Server dot.
Yeah, it's running.
Yeah, it's running, right? So you're getting the answer means the service is running.
Okay.
Check the Apache service whether it is working or running or not.
Apache?
Apache. It means the HTTPD.
Okay.
Web server. Service HTTPD.
HTTPD.
Space status. No, it is also not running, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, start it now. Okay, so yes, that's started successfully.
Mm-hmm.
So Apache here or HTTPD is a service for hosting the website, right?
Right.
So it is hosting the website. So how we can check the website here?
So we need to go to this
browser. Exactly. We need to open the server page here.
You got to put root.
No, not the root. You have to put like the computer name or the local host.
Host, localhost, right?
Yeah, localhost is also okay, or you can type the computer name or computer's IP address, anything.
Yeah.
So we are getting the reply means it is working here.
Right.
This is small, like the checking of our web server. Okay.
Yeah.
So you can check your web servers by configuring a big websites also. Okay.
Okay.
So you can download any HTML website from the internet and you can host it in our server. Okay, so I shown you the basic configuration or the basic hosting of the web services from the server in the previous sessions, right?
Right.
Okay. So now we'll see a new concept. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll just share my screen and I'll show you that the concept. Okay.
All right.
I'm sharing your share and I'm sharing my screen.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, are you getting my screen?
Yes, Mr.
Okay, so now today we are going to see the mail server.
Mail server, okay.
Yeah. So what is mail server?
Who handle all the computers?
Two.
Mail server, okay.
Yeah, mail server it is.
Mail server, I said main.
Okay. So here the mail server, in the name only it is there, right?
Yeah.
So mail server means it is a server which gives the mail services. Okay. So we know about the email, right?
Right.
So what is email?
Email, it's one kind of like a message or post.
Exactly. So it's nothing but the electronic message.
Yeah. Or
electronic like letter. So before this email, we used to have the letters, right? For exchanging the information, for sending our information or our update to the others.
Right.
So the email is a concept of sending that information through or in the electronic format.
Right? Yeah.
Right. So nowadays also we are using that email services like very likely in every organization they are using the email services for updating or for for communicating with the others.
Right.
And some of the companies are maintaining their own domains and some of the companies are not maintaining their own domain. They are relying on the third party domains.
Right.
Okay. So if it is a small organization, then they will not have their own mail server here, we can say.
Yeah.
Okay, so they will depend upon the public mail servers. Like we have the public mail servers like Gmail, Yahoo Mail, or Rediff. Like that, some mail servers are there for, who are providing their services for the public freely.
Right.
Or some other paid services are also there if the users or the customer wants to have high configurations or domain name, own domain names like that.
Right.
Okay. So, or otherwise, the company, if it is a big company, then they can maintain their own mail servers locally to give the mail access to each and every user in the company. Right?
Right.
So, in our company, if we are working in a company, then the company will definitely will provide someone email ID for us, right? For communication,
yeah.
That is.
Yeah.
So, that email ID is coming from the mail server, actually. And that mail server can be hosted locally or can be relied on the public mail servers.
Yeah.
Okay. So here the public mail servers means the mail servers which are providing public mail servers. So in the name only it is there. So public mail server means it is a mail server which provides the mail services publicly for everyone.
Mm-hmm.
So you can get your own mail ID through public mail server or I can get my own mail ID through my public mail server. The same public server we can use, right? So the example for this one is Gmail. For example, you can have the Gmail ID as I can also have that Gmail ID here. So it is available for everyone.
Right.
And free of cost. Right?
Right.
And as well as we have that Yahoo Mail and we have some Rediff or something like that, we have number of mail servers who are providing their mail services freely to everybody in the world.
Right.
Okay, so but some companies, most of the companies we can say, most of the companies will not use these type of public mail servers.
Because, right.
So this public mail server, what it is doing is they are like advertising their companies here.
Right.
Like Gmail is from the Google, we can say like that. Yahoo Mail is from Yahoo and Rediff. These are all the company names here. These are not belongs to our company.
Mm-hmm.
So most of the companies are feeling like this, like our employees should have the mail IDs, which reflects our company name.
Yeah.
Right.
So that is one of the main thing here. That is one type of status or prestige also for the company. Okay. So if the company is a very big company, if they are having the Gmail IDs, then it will not look good in the industry or in the businesses.
Right.
Okay, so everybody, like these type of companies are looking for the private mail servers.
Uh-huh.
Which can have their own mail domain ID, we can say.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, private mail server it is.
Yeah.
Okay, so for example, if the company is IBM, then they have the IBM.com as an email ID domain.
Right.
Like that in the, everywhere, like for example, dharmang.com or for example, hari.com, like that, everyone can have their own private mail servers here if they want to maintain.
Right.
Okay, yeah. So private mail servers. In private mail servers, this IBM.com or Dharmang.com or Hurry.com, these are all just the names or the domain. Right. Okay, or the domain names only. But actually, right. Servers are different here. Okay, so for the private mail servers, we have different services or the servers or softwares, we can say, who are providing these type of services.
Okay. Right.
So for example, see, we have Google Apps. Okay, so have you seen this Google Apps? Google Apps business. So this is a one business tool from Google company, and it provides so many services, and in that one of the main services is a mail service. It can provide right. mail services to any of the company in the world with their company's domain name here.
Right.
Not the gmail.com. It's a company domain name. For example, see, if you want to if you want to have one mail server, that is a private mail server, but if you want to depend upon the Google Apps like that, then they will provide the mail services, means they will provide the email ID with your company name as a domain only.
Right.
Okay, so it is possible here in the Google Apps. Or otherwise, you can use this Outlook 365 for that. From Microsoft. Right. So from Microsoft, we have this Outlook 365. And this Outlook 365 is local-based is there, local disk-based, as well as cloud-based is there.
Right.
And in the cloud-based also, you can use even private, public mail IDs, like hotmail.com or live.com mail IDs here. Or otherwise, you can purchase your private mail services from the Outlook.
Yeah.
Then you will get your company name as the domain name for your mail server.
Right.
Okay, so that is Office 365 and Google Apps. These two are the main private mail servers reputed companies like Google and Microsoft.
Right. Okay.
And other mail servers also there. If you want to maintain your mail server locally in your premises.
Right.
Okay, so we have the mail servers like this, like Exchange Mail Server or Exchange Server. It's the one mail server application from Microsoft.
Uh-huh.
It's a mail service application from Microsoft. So it is just a software like MS Office. You can download this one and you can install it into your server computers. But you need to have the license for using that. Okay, so that is mandatory for every software. Okay, so the Exchange Server will provide the mail services to your entire organization locally.
Right.
Okay, so Exchange Server is a product from Microsoft. And in the same way, we have some other products also from the different companies. Like GroupWise as a tool or software from Groupware operating, Groupware company. Okay, so Groupware, we can send, actually this is from Novel Groupware. GroupWise, or we can simply use the group Novel company name. So this is another private mail server. And it also gives the same type of options of applications like Exchange Server. So
right.
Exchange Server here, it is a very big software, we can say. So very big organizations, big companies, they'll use this Exchange Mail Server as their own mail servers.
Right.
Okay, and in the same way, for our Linux operating systems, Send Mail is there.
Okay.
Send Mail for which type of operating system?
Linux.
Linux. So whatever, now we are using that Linux operating system, and in the Linux operating systems, one mail server is by default, it is there, and that mail server is called as a
Linux.
Send mail. Send mail is the name of the mail server, and Linux is a company name here, or the product or category name. Okay, so
right.
Send mail will work in only Linux type of operating systems.
Right.
Okay, so these are all the mail servers, the private mail servers. Okay, so like this, in our mail servers, we have two different types of mail servers, public mail server and as well as the private mail servers. Right?
Right.
So let's see this image, then you can understand a little bit of the mail servers. So in every mail server, we have three different types of services, we can say. That is, MUA, MTA, and MDA. So here, what is MUA means? MUA is nothing but mail user agent. NAPDM means mail or message transfer unit or transfer agent. Okay, are you getting this?
Yeah.
And mail or message delivery agent. Okay, so there are three parts are there in our send mail or in every mail server.
Right.
Mail message or mail user agent or message or mail transfer agent and mail delivery agent. So here the main user agent means it is a part in the mail server which is used for receiving the mails. It is just an Outlook we have now in our Windows operating systems or in Windows softwares. There is a software called Outlook. It comes along with the MS Offices.
Right.
Okay, so the Outlook is one of the message user agent. Okay. And we have the mail transfer agent, and this is a way or this is a service which is used for transferring the mails from one account to the another account.
Right.
Okay, so example for the mail transfer agent is SMTP. So here the SMTP is a one protocol used for transferring the mails, simple mail transfer protocol it is, used for transferring the mails from one user account to another user account.
Okay.
And one more thing is there here in our types of mail servers, that is MDA. Not types of mail servers, the parts in the mail server. MDA means mail delivery agent, and this is a one set of protocols used for downloading the mails to local computers.
Okay.
So that when the internet connection is not there also, we can check the old mails at least. If you have any, if you got any problems.
Right.
So the examples for the mail delivery agent are two main protocols here. One is POP and another one is IMAP. These are the two example protocols for the mail delivery agent. What these two protocols will do is, these two protocols will download the mails into the local computer. So that user will get those type of mails at any time. When the power is there or power is not there also, they can able to view the mails, the old mails minimum.
Right.
Okay, so like this here, we have three different parts in the mail server. So message user agent, mail transfer agent, and mail delivery agent.
Right.
Okay. So whatever the concept that we are here, we are discussing that send mail will comes under the MTA.
Mm-hmm.
Send mail will comes into the
MTA.
Okay. So got it now?
Right.
One second. I'll be back. I think Hari, you have his email ID. I have sent you a mail for you both at a time.
Okay.
So you can get the email ID from there.
Okay. So same email ID for your Skype ID.
Yeah.
Okay.
So let's start our resume our session. So you got this concept, right? The mail server concept. So the mail server is mainly used for sending and receiving the mails.
Right.
Okay. And it can be a private or public. Public means throughout the internet we can use for free of cost. But our domain names means our email IDs will get the domain names of like their company names, not our ones.
Right.
So if you want your company name as a domain name, then you have to purchase a private mail server here.
Right.
So if you have the facility to host your mail server locally, then you can host, or otherwise you can use this Google Apps or Outlook 365.
Right.
So here Google Apps or Outlook 365, these two will give some benefits. Like you don't have to have any physical server in your premises.
Right.
Just you need to pay the amount, then you will get the main services for all of your employees with your company domain name.
Right.
Okay, so Outlook also will do the same thing. So Outlook 365 or Google Apps or the like we can say the cloud mail services, mail servers. So those servers are presented in the cloud, not in our local premises.
Right.
But if you have like enough manpower and enough the physical resources to maintain the server, then you can own your own mail server locally in our local company. Okay, so you can use the Exchange server from Microsoft or GroupWise or GroupWare from Novell and send mail from Linux.
Right.
Any of the mail server here for sending and receiving the mails between your users.
Right.
So these will work with your company name as a domain name.
Right.
Okay, so and as well as in the mail servers, we have three different parts. One is a MUA, second one is a MTA, and third one is a MDA. Mail user or message user agent, mail transfer agent, and mail delivery agent. So here the delivery agents are the like POP and IMAP, and MTA, mail transfer agents, are the these softwares we can say.
Right.
These all softwares will come under the MTA only.
Uh-huh.
Okay, like send mail is an example. And we right. have message or mail user agent, which is used for accessing or viewing the mails. So
right.
here in our Linux, by default, there is a one command for accessing the mails. That command is the mail.
Uh-huh.
That command itself is a mail.
Yeah.
Okay, so like this, we have that three different parts in each and every mail server architecture.
Okay. Right.
So if you see the real-time uses of this mail server, the mail server parts, you can see this image for getting that. Just see this mail. So here the MUA, MTA, and MDA. So the three parts are involved in this communication. If you see this, okay. So
right.
here, this mailbox belongs to the user.
Uh huh.
And the spool is nothing but it is like a queue for receiving the mails.
Okay.
So here the mail user agent, the first one is a command or a tool used for accessing the mails. And mail transfer agent is a software or protocol used for transferring the mails to other users.
Right.
As well as the that MTA can receive the mails also.
Right.
Okay. And MDA is means like mail delivery agent used for ensuring the delivery of the mails.
Right.
Okay, like this, the three parts will work. Here the mailbox is nothing but the unit of the box which contains the mails of a particular user.
Right.
Okay, so this is our mails server architecture. Now we'll start the virtual machine and we'll see the configuration of the send mail in Linux operating system.
Okay.
You got it?
Yeah.
Let's start it. So I'll take one server from this list.
Uh-huh.
So send mail configuration is very, very easy. Just a few commands. So with that few commands, you can install and configure the send mail. Okay, so we got our server. So let's go to the command prompt and install the package called sendmail.
Right.
Okay, so the package name itself is sendmail.
Yes.
Okay, so this is going to be installed now.
Uh-huh.
Like some error it is giving. CD space slash MNT. Okay, so I think here those files or the applications were not there. Let's check the another folder. Okay, there is a folder with the name dump. Sorry, cd space dump dump, and under the dump there were no files, so nothing. I think the cd is not mounted yet. Okay, so I'll mount it again.
Okay.
So our cd number is sr1. So mount space slash dump dump space slash, so first we need to put the dev dash sr1. So I'm going to mount it to dump folder. So it's mounted. Now let's go to that cd space slash dump and try to install the packages from here. So rpm space -ibh space send mail. So see, it failed dependencies. So we need another package for installing the send mail. So the package name is procmail. No such file or directory. Okay, so now I'm going to install that one. So it's installed completely. Okay, so now we can install the send mail. So that package is also going to be installed. Okay, so all the two packages which are required to run the send mail were installed successfully. Okay, now
right.
Okay. Check the service here, service send mail. I'm directly giving that restart command.
Right.
Okay, now it is started. The send mail is started successfully. Okay. So the send mail installation is completed till now.
Right.
And here, in our Linux machines, the Linux machine is completely command prompt, right? So
right.
Completely command prompt means we can get the graphical way also, but most of the administrators will not use the graphical one. Mostly the command prompt only will be used here. And if you want to see your mails from the command prompt, you can see here.
Okay.
So the mail is a command for verifying your mails.
Okay.
See, after saying the mail, it is saying like one message is there. From whom?
Right.
Actually, the Dharmang user. From Dharmang user, the message is coming.
Right.
Okay, now you can send another mail here. So these are the commands which were being used here to send or receive or delete the mails.
Okay.
Now send a mail here. So just come out from it and say if you want to send a mail. Before that, I'll check the users who are presented here. Here it is. Slash etc. Okay, so if you want to send a mail to other user from here, how we can check or how we can send that, that I'll show you now. And before that, I'm just going to verify that which user accounts are presented here. Okay, so the command for this is slash etc slash passwd file. So if you see that file, then here you'll find the user accounts which were created by you. It's especially like here we have only one account called Venkat and another account is called as Dharma. So you can use any one of the account here to send a mail.
Okay.
For example, I'm sending a mail to Venkat.
Right.
Okay, so after saying this command that mail space Venkat, and here we need to enter the subject of the mail.
Okay.
And after giving the subject, you will not get any information. And from here, directly you can type the matter, which is going to be sent to that Venkat user.
Okay.
So now I'm just typing some information. So after typing the required information, you just press Control Q. Oh, it should not be stopped here. So I unexpectedly pressed that Control Z option. Okay, so we'll send the mail again. Subject test mail. And so here you can type the matter. Okay, so this information is going to be sent to Venkat user. And after that, see if you want to save that or if you want to send that mail, you just press the dot and press enter. So here the dot indicates the end of the line.
Okay.
Special dot it is especially, okay?
Right. So sending is like a Control Q?
We can use that one also. Just you can use the dot and press enter.
Okay.
Okay, now you send a mail to Venkat user, right?
Right.
So now we'll check that. So I'm just going into the command prompt here. Mm-hmm. Another terminal. And I'm going to log in into this computer as a Venkat user. So the username is Venkat and the password is also Venkat, I think. Yes. Now we have logged into the Venkat user account, right?
Right.
Now use the same command mail to check the mails. See, uh-huh. Got a mail from root.
Right.
So the new mail, the N indicates a new mail and one indicates our first mail. And the root is the sender here from whom we got the mail. Right. And on which date and time we got that mail and what is the subject.
Right.
So till subject it will display here, and if you want to see the complete mail, then press that number and press enter.
Okay, so the number is like message number, right?
Yeah, exactly. After the end, we have that number, na? That number you have to press. Okay, now this mail is read it.
Okay.
And here directly you can say reply, or otherwise you can come out from this mail and you can send a new mail. So if you want to send a reply mail, then you have to use a own shortcut here. I'll just check it out and I'll tell you. Yes, reply is a command for replying that particular mail.
Now right.
It's going to be replied. It is going to be sent back to the root user. So here the root user's full name is root@server.mydomain.com.
Right.
Okay. Now you can type some information to...